Throughout the regular season, Clay Feaker and Rod Smith combining for over 3,300 yards and 39 touchdowns. Feaker third in the state in rushing, Smith seventh. Those two going head-to-head tonight. Knights and Hawks squaring off in a stacked sectional 19 out to Arnold Eddings Stadium. Enter Roderick Smith in the Wildcat formation, takes the handoff, breaks one tackle, breaks another. He's going all the way to the house, 51 yards. He's very muddy. I hope they have some bleach out there.
It's like a Tide commercial with like, or like Brett Favre and the Wrangler guys.
Hawks go for two, and it's Diamond Lyman jumping into the end zone. Harding takes a 20-13 lead after the Hawks defense recovers the fumble. It's Smith again, and he's just going to run through, past, all the way again to the end zone, 38 yards for the touchdown. It was 28-13 at that point after another two-point conversion, and it's Harding tonight upsetting Norwell, if you call it an upset tonight, 28-21 the final.
Two words for Harding, stain stick. All right, the winner of that one gets the winner of this one. Number four, Eastbrook, and 10th ranked Leo. Pick it up late in the third. Eastbrook's Tanner Day with a two-yard touchdown run. That gives the Panthers a 26-13 lead, as you see it right there on the scoreboard. But Leo wouldn't give up. Fourth quarter, Leo driving. They get the Panthers 10. Then Connor Kasser punches it in. 26-19 early in the fourth. Leo plays some good D to get the ball back. After a 30-yard pass to the Panthers 13, it's Kasser again, makes it a touchdown, 26 all at that point, but Eastbrook doesn't give up. They drive the ball down to Leo 6, where Jeremy Porter-Jones punts and punches it in, 33-26 at that point. Last chance for Leo, Andrew Such picked off by who else? Jeremy Porter-Jones. That seals it up, and Leo's dream season comes to an end in the first round of the playoffs, 33-26, Eastbrook a winner.
Panthers 10-0 now. 3A action, sectional 19, Heritage at Concordia. The Patriots opening drive, Nick Sheehan to Dan Gibson on the slant, picks up a much-needed first down that sets up this. Sheehan's going to fake the handoff, keeps it himself, punches it in from a yard out. That's 7-zip Pats. Concordia back on the option here. It's Michael Starks to Charles Thorpe. He does it all the way to the end zone, ties the game at 7, but unfortunately, the Dean Dorfler farewell tour ends tonight as Heritage pulls out a 3-point win, 31-28.
Final game from Sectional 19, defending 3A state champs. Belmont at home against Blacker. They're fired up with those Braves. Belmont, third play from scrimmage. This is a good idea. Nick Hall takes
healthy.
It. Yeah, he goes 60 yards for the touchdown. The 3A reigning state championship game MVP, 203 yards. Three touchdowns. Talk about this. Watch this. A little what we like to call chicanery. Right there, Hall on the conversion.
Is that
makes
a no
it
look?
8-zip Belmont. It's like, you know, Magic Johnson over the head, no look, all that good stuff. Belmont, still over 3 minutes left in the first quarter. Daniel Meyer, he punches it in. 144 yards, I should say. Two touchdowns for Meyer. And Belmont wins by the score 50-0.
Let's head to 2A. Huge matchup at Manchester. Bishop Lewis always dangerous in the playoffs at 8-1. Manchester. Knights already up 3-zip. Handoff to Ken Mullen. He's going to pick up 12 big yards there for the Knights. That's going to set up James Kanapke. You know what? He's just going to keep it himself and run it in from 15 yards. Takes it inside the 10, and that sets up the Knights' first touchdown of the game. Kanapke's going to look toward the end zone for Eric Sorg. Sorg catches it. It's
nice.
A touchdown. Knights up 10-zip at that point, and Lewis hands the Squires their second loss of the season, 45-21.
Have they always had red pants?
Sure.
All right, sectional 27 to sectional 26. Garrett versus Woodland, Etzler Field, second quarter. Garrett, Zach McCrary off the pass from Spencer Burns. He runs it in, 14-zip. Garrett, we see more from Mr. McCrary. This guy's a little ball of muscle, one of those wrestler guys. He's talented. The fullback takes the kick return back for a touchdown, makes it 20-0 Railroaders, and Garrett is victorious by the score of 32-0. Other scores from sectional 26, it's Eastside losing 44-0. They get the Garrett Railroaders, and as we move on, Central Noble edges Witco, kind of a surprise in that one, 29-26 in Fairfield, Prairie Heights. That one got a little ugly, 78-6.
Let's head to Class 1A. Adams Central making the trip to Turtletown facing 6th-ranked Cherubusco. They got this guy called Kyle Mathewson. We called his name a few times.
He's
call it again. That's a 12-yard pickup. Then the Eagles go to the air. It's Kyle Monk to Jordan Turnover. Unfortunately, turnovers plaguing the Eagles tonight. They would fumble this one away. They had two big turnovers on the night, and the Flying Jets take advantage. Dalton Combs to James Agler picks up 15 yards. That would lead to this. It's Combs to Ben Mishler. Mishler, 188 yards receiving tonight, two touchdowns. The Flying Jets go to Turtletown and beat the Eagles tonight, 20-13 the final. And other scores in Class 1A, AC now gets Southwood after they beat North Miami 14-3. And on the other bracket, it's Fremont beating Northfield 29-6, and Southern Wells beat South Adams 28-15.
All right, you just saw 15 games from Northeast Indiana, but there's much more to be seen online.
Absolutely, and as you know by now, we always put our extended highlights on Wayne.com. Tonight is no exception. We'll have all those games plus some post-game reactions from Snyder on there as soon as we get done after the show.
And while you're in cyberspace, check out the Gridiron Matchup section where you can predict who wins on Sundays in the NFL.
And while you're there, sign up for our weekly $50 Marathon Gas Card Giveaway. This week's winner is Mr. Robert Morgan from Bluffton. Of course, he likes the Tigers, so Nick Nicholas, he gets $50 as well. Register on the high school sports page at Wayne.com. Play of the Week coming up next.
All right, it's a Drive Alive Play of the Week, and it comes from the Game of the Week. Who knew Snyder was this much better than Kokomo? Tyler Bevilia, bye-bye. 25-yard touchdown. Snyder victorious over the previously unbeaten Wildcats. Congratulations to Coach Tippmann and Tyler and the rest of the crew.
Comets 58th home opener, of course. You got to have Bob Chase on hand. His 57th home opener. Of course, the cup was there. Guy Dupuy and the guys got their championship rings. All that matters in this one, Comets win 2-1 the final. They get 2 second period goals from Thomas Templa and Kaylee Schrock to open up the season at home with a W.
The 14th season of the Highlight Zone. We've never had 15 games plus 15. Comments before.
It's a bunch of numbers.
We'll have it again next week. Second round of sectionals. We got to improve on it. Do even better.
Bigger and better.
Why not?